How often do you fail to solder or desolder an electronic component? I want to share the basics with you. I will explain what temperatures need to be set and explore the tools and methods that help to solder quickly and with high quality. Let's start with the soldering iron. Before you buy a soldering iron, find one that allows you to adjust the temperature. I don't recommend soldering irons without temperature control because you won't even roughly know what temperatures is being transferred from the soldering iron tip to the PCB joint. This is very critical. When soldering electronics, it's essential to know that exact temperature at the iron tip. That's because modern electronic components are very sensitive to high temperatures and can be damaged due to overheating. Also, when the temperature exceeds 350 degrees of the Celsius, soldering flux begin to burn more actively on the iron tip, which leads to carbon buildup, requiring more frequent cleaning. There will be more smell from the burning, the molten solder will flow worse, and the soldering iron tip will wear out faster due to overheating. For me, the comfortable tip temperature for soldering lead-based PCBs and alloy is 320 degrees of the Celsius. For lead-free is 350 degrees of the Celsius, 30 degrees higher. Why do I think so? First of all, 20 years of experience, IPC 610 specialist. If the temperature is set below 310 degrees of the Celsius, it becomes difficult to heat the joint to the melting point of leaded solder. This increases the time the iron tip stays on the joint, which can cause PCB delamination and component overheating. One of the most important factors in soldering is contact time, ideally no more than 2 seconds. When I try to desolder component, the heat transferring through the iron tip to three bodies, to the component, to the board, and to the solder. For melting leaded solder, I must raise the joint temperature on PCB to at least 183 degrees of the Celsius, and for lead-free solder, at least 220 degrees of the Celsius. But because the heat from the tip quickly spreads through the board, I can't raise the temperature at the joint. It stays too low. The solder doesn't melt and the soldering iron tip sticks to the PCB joint. This indicates insufficient temperature at the soldering iron tip. One key issue in this case is low thermal capacity of the tip. Thin tip have a small cross section. Thin tip don't store enough the heat and thermal transfer is limited. As a result, many people just increase the iron tip temperature to 400 degrees of the Celsius if it's adjustable, and that's a big mistake. That's an extreme temperature for the PCB laminate FR4 and dangerously high for almost any electronic components. You will just burn them. And the iron tip itself will wear out much faster. You definitely shouldn't do that. For reference, in electronic manufacturing, the average lifespan for soldering iron tip is 10,000 solder joints. Write in the comments your soldering temperature. And right now, I will show you a few ways to solve temperature-related problems. Option 1. Use a thicker iron tip. It holds more heat, which enough to heat the joint to melting point of solder. But it's extremely inconvenient to use a thick tip for small SMD components. It's like trying to solder a phone connector with a hot axe. Option 2. Use a professional soldering station that can quickly restore heat even to a thin iron tip in real time. Any modern soldering station, GBC, Valier, Metcol, and others, handles temperature control and recovery extremely well. For most daily soldering tasks, a professional soldering station is sufficient without any extra tools. The heat compensation speed of professional station is very high. No matter what heater installed in the station, inductive or resistive, you can solder a connector easily holding the iron tip for just 1-2 seconds on each pin, and the temperature will stay stable throughout. Time is critical because long contact time causes the solder alloy to overheat and the flux burns off and solder flow degrades. I use gel Diamond Flux FN231 for components and liquid Diamond Flux FN232 for wires. These are no clean soldering fluxes, highly recommended, link in description. But sometimes I need to solder or desolder large components and there are big copper planes inside the PCB. In this case, I still can't raise the temperature at the joint. Option 3. A bottom preheating table. This is one of the most essential tools for soldering and repairing PCB. The goal of the preheater is to saturate the PCB with the heat from below, so that the heat applied from above by soldering iron tip or hot air doesn't spread across the board, but instead helps raise the temperature directly at the joint. This allows to change components quickly and effectively, without overheating the PCB and without damaging the laminate or electronic components. The bottom heater is usually set to 180-200 degrees of the Celsius. Place the PCB on the preheating table and wait around 2 minutes to absorb the heat. Half inch gap between the PCB and the heater. As a result, the PCB temperature will be around 100-110 degrees of the Celsius. For the PCB, 100 degrees of the Celsius is not critical. It won't harm it or any plastic components. At this point, you can easily solder using any iron tip at 320 degrees of the Celsius or even lower. Many viewers watch my YouTube channel without subscribing. Press subscribe button, like this video, leave your comments or ask your question. I also post short reels on my Instagram, follow me there too. In description of this video you can find links to my Instagram, my website with Soldering Fluxes, Diamond Flux, links to consulting and outsourced PCB repair services. Thank you for watching, see you next video.